Hello and welcome to my first YouTube video. Today I want to show you my simple way to turn Procreate drawings into vectors. I often get asked how I do this, so I decided it's easier to just make a video about it than trying to describe it every time. The whole process can be done entirely on the iPad. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to vectorize a single color design. If you're interested in learning how to turn Procreate designs with several colors into vectors, I created a Skillshare class that shows you how to do that. You can find the link in the description underneath this video. And with this link, new Skillshare students can also get 2 months for free, so you can watch my class and all the other fantastic classes that Skillshare has to offer. I'm in the lucky situation that I'm location independent, and I often travel for months at a time. And depending on the trip and the type of work I want to do while traveling, I often take only one of my iPads with me and leave my laptop at home. I use this method a lot for t-shirt design, especially when I travel with my iPad mini alone. I really enjoy drawing on my iPads and with Procreate, but for t-shirt design you need quite a large canvas. I do not mind zooming in and out when drawing, and the small screen doesn't bother me, but I have a hard time with the limited amount of layers the iPad mini gives me. For example, when I design on a canvas with a size of 4500 by 5400 pixels, the iPad mini in Procreate gives me only 7 layers. That's not enough for my workflow with sketching and inking and coloring and testing things. So I usually design with a smaller canvas size. For example, on a square canvas with 2000 by 2000 pixels, I get 67 layers instead of only 7. That works much better for me. When I am done drawing, I just vectorize my design and afterwards scale it to a bigger size and I'm good to go. But you can also use this method to prepare your Procreate drawings for specific printing methods or to create vector-based logos out of Procreate. The apps I'm going to use are obviously Procreate and Affinity Designer, which is a vector program for the iPad. Unfortunately, it cannot trace design and turn them into a vector. Usually I would just do this on my laptop and use Illustrator. But as I said, when I am traveling, I often don't have my laptop with me. So I'm going to show you two different ways how you can do it on the iPad. The first option is to convert it into a vector for free on the internet. The second option is using Adobe Capture. Both work equally well, in my opinion. But enough talking, let's do it. So as a first step, we obviously need a design in Procreate. I already imported one of my ready t-shirt designs, and as you can see, it's only a simple black and white design. This is important because to vectorize it, you will need a simple black and white design because it will give you the best output. All the black parts are going to be turned into a vector and all the white parts are going to be removed, so make sure to set up your design accordingly. As a next step, we are going to export it. To do so, you just click on the tool symbol and choose JPEG. And I'm just gonna save it on my iPad. So let's start with the first way, to just use one of the online converters. If you Google for tools to convert pixel graphics into vectors, you will find lots of different options. The one I am using is on the webpage onlineconverting.com/vectorize. The reason why I like this one is because it gives you different options for the output. So you can convert to an Adobe Illustrator file or an SVG or a PDF. So it gives you lots of options. We're gonna choose for now the SVG. And we go ahead and upload our image. And go done. And it's uploading and converting. And now we can download it. And it will automatically save it to the download section of your iPad. The next step is to go to Affinity Designer. And we're gonna load the image from the cloud. So today at 5. This is ours. And as you can see, It's perfectly turned into a vector, and all the lines are still crisp and clear. The second option is to use a program like Adobe Capture. So if you open Adobe Capture, I already uploaded it into my library. So if I go here and I go Export As and SVG, I can directly copy it into Designer. And again, we have a very nicely vectorized image. So yeah, it's really as easy as this. So now I can just go ahead and do with this image whatever I want. I can create a t-shirt design with it, or I can just add some white background to make it look nice on dark t-shirts. So I hope you found this little tutorial helpful. And if you would like to know how you can turn colored Procreate designs into vectors, please watch my Skillshare class. I'm looking forward to seeing you there, and don't forget, with the link below, you get 2 free months, so you can actually watch this class for free. Let me know if this method works for you as well, and if you have any questions, please feel free to ask in the comments. I hope you have an amazing day. Bye.